I feel good when I see you.
Don King and Donald Trump, the Dons, on top of the boxing world.
Here he is now, my man!
The fellow showman had a heavyweight star in Mike Tyson. In 1988, Tyson's knockout of Michael Spinks in just 91 seconds made more money than any other boxing event at the time.
Gate of $12.3 million is the largest live gate in the history of sport, not only fighting.
Trump, King, Tyson, and Atlantic City in the 1980s were on a roll.
Trump is the missing ingredient in the fight between who's going to have the biggest and the best events, Atlantic City or Vegas in boxing.
The good times didn't last. In 1991, Mike Tyson was arrested for the rape of an 18-year-old. On February 10th, 1992, an Indiana jury convicted him.
Mr. Trump will be making a statement.
3 days after his conviction, before his sentencing, Donald Trump held a press conference proposing a deal that Tyson do no jail time.
As you know, I'm a very strong believer in harsh punishment, including the death penalty. But we think it's probably, in this particular case, a lot more good can be done by having Mike Tyson pay a substantial award, both to the victim, subject to court approval, and creating award for people that were abused or raped in the state of Indiana.
8 days after that, on NBC, Trump blamed the victim.
It's my opinion that to a large extent, Mike Tyson was railroaded in this case. You have a young woman that was in his room, his hotel room, late in the evening at her own will. You have a young woman who was seen dancing for the beauty contest, dancing with a big smile on her face, looked happy as could be.
Trump's efforts didn't keep his heavyweight moneymaker out of prison. 2 months later, Tyson was sentenced to 6 years in prison. He served three.
Thank you, Mr. Trump.
Mike Tyson was an investment worth protecting. By 1990, two of Trump's Atlantic City casinos were on a losing streak. Trump looking to change the odds. In November 1990, Trump outbid Las Vegas' Caesars Palace for an unheard of $11 million to host Evander Holyfield versus George Foreman. Boxing legend Bob Arum promoted George Foreman, Kathy Duva's husband Dan, now deceased, and their main events promoted the reigning champ, Evander Holyfield.
This was huge.
Big as it gets. The battle of the ages.
Concerned that Trump bid too much, and with headline news that two of his casinos were struggling, promoters had a rare lockbox clause written into the contract, ensuring money from the fight couldn't be used to support Trump's failing properties.
It was Trump throwing out these crazy numbers, and the people working for Trump telling him, Donald, we can't afford this in Atlantic City.
Just days after the contract was signed, Trump found a way to save money and keep the fight. On January 17, 1991, the U.S. began bombarding Iraq during the first Gulf War. Days later, Trump informed both Duva and Arum he was invoking the act of war clause in the contract, and they would have to settle for less.
So this is a threat to your business?
This was unprecedented, especially for this was Donald Trump, my God, who wouldn't trust him?
With 7 weeks to the fight, Arum proposed they take it back to Las Vegas. Then he says Donald Trump really shocked him.
Trump said, if you did that, I'm going to sue you. I said, what are you talking about? You say that the contract is terminated. We'll go to Las Vegas, as hard as that is, and do the fight, and you're going to sue us?
With the fight looming and the prospect of a long legal battle, Arum and Duva says Trump had them over a barrel, leaving them little choice but to agree to his terms. It's a deal that still stings today.
If your claim to fame is that you've taken money from other people and not delivered what you promised, that doesn't make you a genius businessman. That makes you a thief.
Bob Arum says he never did a deal directly with Trump again. CNN sent multiple requests for comment from Donald Trump about the victim blaming and business deal allegations. His campaign has not responded. Inducted into the New Jersey Boxing Hall of Fame, Trump was credited with turning the town by the sea into the mecca of boxing. Still, Donald Trump never hosted another major title fight at any of his properties after invoking the act of war clause in the contract for the Holyfield Foreman fight. Both Mike Tyson and Don King have endorsed Donald Trump for president. Miguel Marquez, CNN, New York.